So after much attempts to doing a couple mountains in the last 2 days, only to be curtailed by either private property or weapons testing sites or whatever, I think we finally got one that we can do. But now we're short on time. So, didn't get to do much research about this. I do know that we aren't using the trailhead. We use the power lines road to get to the base of the mountain. And we're just gonna go up from there because of time. But I'll tell you about the trailhead later in the video. So, here we go. Some relevant info, the dirt trail road or path stops and you just kind of have to wing it from here. And even the routes that other people took showed them taking this route. So I'm gonna kind of wing it. There's kind of a trail in this wash. I'm sure if there is, it'll become more defined at some point. Otherwise, no biggie. Our objective is very obvious. I don't know if you can hear that. Those are coyotes. There's a couple ridges that run from east to west. As long as you're on one of them, I believe you should be okay. All right, we're making some really good progress really quick. I don't know why, but I always get excited when I see a cairn. It tells me that, hey, you're going the right way. You're not lost, as you are in all things in life. That's pretty cool. Yay. Very reminiscent of the Robledo Mountain climb with these little rock walls to bypass. And the rocks are really rough too, which is good for traction. Sidestepping here. Now I gotta figure this out. It was a cute little scramble, nothing serious. We're getting there. I'd say another 10 minutes, we'll be at the summit. This is the last crux, really, I think, to overcome. We are running into some slight mobility issues. So, just be careful if you decide to do this segment. Summit's right behind it, though, I think. It's very doable, just take your time. It's not bad. All right, got over that last wall and we're here. Yeah. That's the summit. Yes. Ooh, shiny rock. I'm going back for it. That's it. Oh, survey marker. Woo! Find. It's a vein of quartz. Things I do for my craft. Well, it's time to get down this thing before the sun sets. And I need both hands. Definitely not as scary as the San Mateo Tower, that's for sure. Safety first. Probably put this away. Okay, it's the only part of the mountain that I'm actually concerned about, just because how awkward it was going up, but I think we'll be fine. Here are the coyotes. Sun's about to set. I'm trying not to die. And directly ahead of us, I believe, is Cox Peak in the Petrillo Mountains, which are a bunch of dead volcanoes, if I'm not mistaken. Here's a pleasant discovery. There is a trail sort of like in this section, which is between the two fingers. We went up one of the, we went up one of them, so. And that concludes Bishop's Cap. And I'm doing everything in my power not to provoke this herd of cows. I don't know anything about cows. I'm sure they're nice, wonderful creatures. But they have some of their young with them and they're all staring at me. Staring at me like I just ate their cousin or something. This is a good climb. I like this one. It's not the highest point in the area, obviously, but it's still very pretty. And I would recommend this for people that have experienced the basics and want to try something a little different than just your average trail. So this definitely gives you that opportunity to experience very briefly some scrambling. So that's pretty cool. And there's some cool surprises on top, the tower. So yeah, not bad. I enjoyed it. It was a good time. So with that, you guys, I hope you enjoyed watching as much as I did doing it. Although I think I had more fun. Farewell. Deuces. La 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 la. The acoustics are lovely.